kidzos, Jans and Joneses and gents.
That's a lot of J's and G's.
Yep. How's everybody doing?
Hi.
Been a minute. Mortaring Wars back here with you. We are with you.
BBC Radio.
Oh, been a hell of a couple of weeks. For anybody that follows me on social media, you know, I had kind of like a heart scare. Thought I was having a heart attack. Went in the hospital, stayed overnight for observation. Found out I had AFib. Wearing a monitor right now to figure out exactly how, and or not how, but how bad it is. But I'm not feeling too bad, just a little weak in that. So we had that going on, and this man has had all kinds of festivities with high school because tomorrow is his graduation.
Mm-hmm.
And you are looking at the 2019 BW Prom King as well.
Oh, yeah.
He was prom king. He's got another scholarship. He has gotten two scholarships for his going to school for multimedia. So we're all kinds of proud of him here at the Downey residence. The
Pop Culture Palace.
Yes, here at the Pop Culture Palace. So, like I said, it's been a quick minute. I don't think we've talked about our feelings on a couple big things that's going on in our world of fandom, and one would be Endgame. and there's Tori for her
visit.
For her visit as
Hello,
usual.
Cat.
Thoughts on Endgame to share for everybody? I loved it. That was
How
great.
Couldn't you love it?
That was, everything was awesome. The battle was awesome.
That battle, that's up
yeah,
there.
What happened with Tony at the end was awesome. Perfect bookend to these the series. Yeah, I mean, that, you know, really enjoyed
Cap
it.
Cap even, too, honestly, if you want to.
Yeah, real cool conclusions to everybody's story arc. So I thought that was pretty awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Really enjoyed it. Can't wait to get it on DVD we can watch it a million times and analyze all the battles and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah, just went, you know, really well.
And then the other big thing, of course, has been the Game of Thrones just ended this
past.
Now,
I'd say how could you not love it, but apparently people are upset.
Well, you guys, it's probably most of these, like, real, real young guys. Will you guys please quit crying over every little thing? Every little thing can't go baby's way, okay? I thought it was great
satisfying.
And very filling and satisfying. And
I think it all made sense.
Fitting,
how it ended.
Filling is what I am right now, but fitting how everything ended up. And you know, I was as big a Danny fan as everybody, but you know, they had to show that arc and how you know somebody can
now
can change.
The complaint with that I've heard is that like.
Really like, cool imagery in that last episode,
oh,
too.
Oh, yeah, with the dragon wings. That was cool.
Thought Arya was real cool, killing the Night King. Spoiler, you know, if you guys haven't watched it by now, sorry about your luck. But yeah, man, you know they said today that there's no way to have Arya spinoff, which is unfortunate. That would be so cool to see her
said that?
Adventures. HBO.
Stupid HBO.
But it would be really cool to see that, but. So that's been big news. Everybody here at our house liked it, and most of the people we know that's in Thrones liked it. I don't know that I've found any of these crybabies that are signing petitions.
I mean,
when we got a petition for Danny DeVito to play Wolverine, you know, it's a pretty weird, sad situation. Mm-hmm. What was the other big petition they were bitching about here recently?
Well, petition with patents and.
Oh yeah, about him being Batman.
And it could be worse.
And
it
you know,
be
give
better,
the guy a chance.
It could be worse.
You know, everything he's been in hasn't been like Twilight. And to be honest, the first Twilight movie was all right, except for the sparkly part.
Wait, have you seen them?
I've seen them all. Yeah,
really?
Yeah, because Case read all the books.
Oh,
Mr. Lay read all the books.
So were the movies as other crap then, for the most part?
You know.
My thing was,
guys are vampires and they were like way too nice.
I mean, too nice.
I mean, if the underworld vampires came after them, they would totally rip them a new butt, you know.
Yeah.
So, but it is what it is. Give the guy a chance. I think he'll be all right. I liked him in Harry Potter, so, you know, I think he'll be all right.
Where he died? Huh? Where he died?
Yeah, but he was pool and everything for that. Tori, will you get out of our shot? There she is, her up close and personal.
She's just curious, everybody.
Yeah, one of these days we're going to have Meet the Cats episode.
Yeah, if we can round them up, that's going to be my job.
All six of them.
And it's not going to
be
pretty.
Yeah, you're going to be the cat rounder.
I can't do it. Three of them are too skittish. I cannot get them.
You can do... Oh, that's why we got... You know, you can turn a clip off. And in fact, we don't have to do one shot like we do this
one. I don't want to be chasing cats around the house for 2 hours.
You want to go to Toshi Station to get some power converters.
Yeah. I don't care
about... your mystery minis.
I don't care about whining about this, because that's absurd. I'm not doing that.
So anyway, if I forget to tell you, everybody have a very happy Memorial Day weekend. Summer's officially going to be here.
It's Memorial Day weekend?
Yeah.
Crap.
Yep.
Where have I been?
And congrats again to you on your successful completion of high school and graduation. Yeah. And like I say, everybody enjoy the time with your families. Be safe. And thank you for all those that have... served, and all those that have went before us, as we think about our people in service and our family and friends that have passed. So I'm planning on going up to where my dad grew up. He grew up in Kitzmiller, Maryland. I think it's Maryland, but anyway, it's about an hour drive from here, and we're going and spend the day with family if everything's okay. And I get a good report from him. I got to the doctor tomorrow. So.
What was the knockabout?
I'm hoping I can drive again. I haven't been able to drive since I had my scare.
What was this?
So, you know, that was knock on wood.
Oh.
So, you know, if you guys are out there and all that, say one for me, the man upstairs, and hope everything's all right.
I thought you were Sheldon Cooper for a second. Penny.
Yeah.
Penny.
So, and that just ended, too.
Yeah. There lots of endings.
The only other thing coming up, we got the Spider-Man Far From Home
looks pretty good.
The trailer looks awesome, I think. It's cool how they're going to incorporate. I'm hoping in the suit, Tony Stark's voice starts being his.
Oh, his new voice.
That would be very cool.
That's kind of like, that'd be teary. Like every time you get the suit, Mr. Stark, you're dead.
But that would be kind of cool, though. But we'll see what they do with it.
Oh, and then Rise of Skywalker, new photos.
Oh, yeah, new photos, Vanity Fair. Awesome looking. I love the cockpit shot. In fact, it's my Facebook cover photo. I made the cockpit shot in the Falcon with the smooth man himself, Colt 45.
I'm excited.
Woody Williams. And
I'm excited for this speeder chase or whatever this is with horses and whatever.
Yeah, it all looks cool. So can't wait.
And Kerry Russell's character looks interesting.
Looks like we're going to have some cool stuff coming up this summer. Also, Endgame passed Avatar, so congrats to them on that.
And then one day we're going to get that Lord of the Rings TV series, whenever it comes out.
Yep, can't wait for that, too. That's when
whatever they do with it.
Good time in life.
Don't ruin it. Please don't ruin it.
To be a fan. So, what do you say we show them some stuff? What do you want to show first that we've acquired in all of our travels since the last time the past month?
Well, I'm over here fiddling with this, so I might
as well. Fiddle further. Tell them what we acquired. And most of this I had to get online, didn't I?
Yeah. Okay.
I'm seeing what? One, two, three, four things that I got had to get that we found, and everything else is online out of dozen or so things we're showing you guys. Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna have some water. Right.
With these, I'm gonna try to mimic the shots from the cartoon because I know it well. So this one, start back here. That's what he does. Yes, this is our Beast, our new Hasbro Marvel Legends Beast.
Hey, I just finally got tired of trying to find him, and I just paid a couple extra bucks more to order him online.
More or less worth it.
Yeah.
Very well posed figure. The handstand.
It didn't come with a Build-A-Figure piece and that, but I wasn't worried about that.
Yeah, you don't want him.
I don't care about the Build-A-Figure in this one.
And the one handstand.
Yeah, his hands are cool, man.
Only complaint we found is that the through the character, the face sculpt is a little bit too ferocious.
Yeah, I wish they would have put an additional face sculpt in there for us. Just to like a serious little, one where he looks like he's trying to figure out some scientific
problem. A little gentler, like with the glasses or whatever, yeah. Maybe with like the eyes. But overall, I mean, apart from that, he's very good. So then keeping with the X-Men theme, we'll connect to Jubilee, which her shot in it was just basically this, up close and
violent. Yay! Bret Hart! Remember the... Don't you know who I am? What am I, some kind of ass? Anyway, you've seen the Juggernaut video.
I hope you have.
Please go see it.
Please. It's one of the best things ever made by anybody.
Countless hours of laughter the first time you see it. But anyway.
Hours of laughter.
Tell us more about Jubilee.
Yeah, this one looks really well.
She came with a bubblegum face sculpt, most of you guys know, I'm sure.
And like two additional pairs of glasses, which I thought was kind of weird, but... Yeah, Jubilee's nice. Pretty simplistic costume.
So slowly but surely getting our X-Men. If somebody explain to me in the comments, why in the living hells is the Rogue
and Cyclops
figure $1 million when you're trying to buy them online? It's like, I've seen none of them any cheaper.
We need
like
them.
$60.
We need them.
We're missing.
And of the older ones, we need them. We still need a Jean Grey, and then Iceman and Kitty Pryde. And then that's not even counting, like, we still need to get the Angel, and then, like, if we can hopefully get an updated Professor X, the...
Even though I like my Professor X, I have, but still...
Yeah, but the reason I want to get it is because it's, like, same company, and it matches,
well,
like,
here's
the
thing. I think they nailed the figure, but I just think the thing he rides in just looks like two pieces of cheap plastic.
But that's how it was in the show, though.
Yeah, I know, but I think they could have did some little more details to it to make it not look like just a hunk of plastic.
This is, I know,
the figure, not love the figure.
I'm just saying that that's how it would go with it.
And of course,
Jin Lee, that's...
This was a present for the Mystery Lady, or her favorite figure, and she's
going
to allow us to display it with our X-Men.
Yeah.
Man Gambit.
Like that he came with two different hand options.
So. Although she still prefers the Select over the Legend.
Well, the Select's a little bit larger, maybe, I don't know. I think this would
be hair is different, isn't it?
Not entirely. I'm looking at it up there right now. It just goes a little more to the...
He's up here. So.
Yeah, but, yeah, nice Gambit figure.
So, yeah, that was the extent of what the Legends we've gotten recently. We didn't... Was there any more than Endgame ones? We got all
no.
ones of them we wanted.
But we are excited for the new Endgame ones.
Yeah, I got the two of the Spider-Man one pre-ordered. The Mysterio and the... what's his name?
Scorpion.
But
we'll be glad for Pepper Rescue and...
Yeah. On the other end game,
War
wave.
Machine and Shuri, and then also hopefully it'd be cool to get the Professor Hulk as well.
Yeah,
that'd be a good build a figure.
And speaking of build a figure, we are still looking for the parts to build Manus.
Yeah,
we need what is it? The
head and legs.
Head and legs for the Manus. Way back, what wave was she in?
2014, like Guardians 1. No, that was Guardians 2. That was my mistake.
We've still been trying to build figures. We got to build a few pieces we could trade, too. We need to do a... There's a video on here where I show them. It's in the title where I show what pieces we have. If anybody needs it, check that video out. And we'd be glad to hook you up or trade or whatever. Mm-hmm. What's next?
This, our newest Black Series acquisition, is this Battle Droid. From the newest wave. It's the only one that I've been able to come across in person, apart from Admiral Holdo, but we don't really want her. It looks like we're not going to pay
for her. Right, I'm just going to, if I find her, I'll pick her up.
She currently has Padme, Mace Windu, and Dryden Voss pre-ordered.
Yeah, even though they've been out, I'm on one of them things where it's like, when they get a restock, I'll get them all.
Yeah,
so.
We've heard from other sources that, it's pretty good overall, just to be careful.
We're still waiting on them, and we're still waiting on General Grievous. We got all them ordered, just waiting on them to
And the new announcements for them are exciting, too. Count Dooku, Jar Jar,
I know, I can't wait
to
get
a loose
get
Dooku. I'm getting a loose Dooku.
And I'll even get Jar Jar, just, you know, because they've not done one. I'm sure he'll look cool.
No, I'd say that, like, Black Series might be, like, the definitive Star Wars figures.
Yeah, they're getting there, especially for the price. I mean, I know a lot of you guys get like the Mezco and the what's the other big brand? SH Figure Arts and all those, and you know, and they're cool and all. I like them and everything, but it's just way more in our budget to stick with the Black Series, you know. Mm-hmm. What else we got?
We'll
do. Oh yeah, I did find the Sting. Nate, if you see this, I'm still looking for one for you. I picked up one for me. It was right before you had told me you needed one. I got one, and so still looking for one for you, buddy. If you got or anything, please let me know. I'm Nate Simmons, the Syndicate Santa, awesome guy. Love the new video with your diorama too, buddy. If you're watching, that's pretty cool with your Weapon X. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I've got, man, the old school Sting before the Crow makeup. Mm-hmm. Like, don't get a lot of wrestling figures this way. Once in a while, I'll see one of the classic ones. I'm still looking for the Bob Back one that was the Walmart exclusive. So anybody out there has it and wants to hook a guy up, we'll let me know and we'll trade or do something, mm-hmm. and I'll find something for you. Mm-hmm. What next? The Pops we got?
Yeah, I guess we go to Pops. This is the...
I may have already showed this, but if I didn't, I'll show it again.
Yeah, this... just
nice, I got Owen the Gladiator Hulk, so I got him really good price. Really love the detail on these guys.
Yeah, it's a good one. Certainly.
Certainly. Mm. Certainly!
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. But yeah, he's good. Then we get one here. This.
Yeah, this was a gift for the mystery lady.
Yes, if anyone out there is a fan of Gargoyles, classic nostalgia from 90s.
What's his name?
His name's Goliath.
Goliath.
Very interesting show. I remember waking up, you know, as a kid, and TV would be on in the middle of the night, and I'd always have it on, like, Disney, and they'd be playing reruns of it, and I'm like, what is this amazing show? It was cool.
Yeah, yeah, I've seen a few back in the day. My thing was, it seemed like I could never catch it when it was on for some reason, but anyway. But he's a cool figure. I'm glad she liked it and that.
Yeah.
And then, who's next? You got a couple more there, don't you?
Yeah, we'll go with these
this
two.
This was the...
two Walgreens exclusive Star Wars ones we found from the prequels. You don't find that too often. The one we got as a gift for, this is Sith Anakin.
We got that Sith. He's Casey's mystery lady's favorite. And we got him for her for Mother's Day. Really cool.
And also there, we found this one, which was just amazing.
I love it.
This Jango Fett with the blaster base, like the jetpack boost. That's great.
Yeah, if you guys haven't, if you guys get Pops, haven't picked them up, there's a couple good ones to get. Especially Star Wars is one of my main lines. I do Star Wars, MCU, and the rock and roll ones, so... definitely like them. And then over there is
the another X-Men one, this Dark Phoenix.
Really cool.
Look on the back. There's a couple cool ones.
I'm excited. You know, I know a lot of people have, like, busted on the movie, but I'm excited. I think it's going to do well, too, because it's probably going to get out when it's out for...
good ones on the back, too.
For our genre of...
as you can see.
...fandom. So I'm looking forward to it coming out, and I think... it looks like Sophie's going to do an awesome job in it, so looking forward to that. But that was also a gift for the mystery lady.
Mm-hmm. And then before we get to the biggies, we have a little Lannister.
I'd like to get the other three in this set.
Jon, Daenerys, and Night King.
I'd like to pick them up eventually, but we found them.
Use my senior quote. Because he's good.
Yep. Tell him what quote you used.
I'm not going to say the whole thing, but basically, scene one. No, his. Wait. Season one, episode one. First scene with Jon Snow. He gives Jon a good bit of advice. That's where you'll find the gem at. And honestly, I read that chapter in the book the other day. I went upstairs and read a little more. Mm-hmm. And at the end, there's this great description where after he says it to John, he walks away and Martin writes something like, "For a moment, like, as Tyrion entered the door and his shadow came out, his shadow was so big that he looked like a king," or something like that.
Oh,
like,
cool.
I was like, that's good.
Yeah, that's pretty awesome. I loved where his story ended up in the movie, right back pretty much where he belonged, so that was cool. And the last scene of them all sitting at the table, it was just like, everything, all that bad crap happened, but then it was like, ended up just being back to business as usual.
And good people in the thing.
So yeah, and he just nailed that role. Nobody else that could have done that. I'm just so hope he gets another award or something for it.
Mm-hmm.
And then show them the big boys here.
Big ones. We have
to add to my madness.
New.
I got the gallery, new
gallery statues from Justice League.
Justice League.
So this is the Batman.
Batman, which I think is awesome. Love the pose, action scene.
Yeah, the pose has pros and cons. Like, I like the pose, but I just don't like how much, like, leftover space there is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it's definitely cool. A lot like the, reminds me a lot of the Black Panther one I have.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's true.
Boy, he's jumping over there, so I can just a little bigger. Mm-hmm. And I just got this one in the mail today. I've been watching these online and finally
we
won
got
it
a
in
few
an auction.
This is one of the few things we got in the mail today that decided this Justice League Wonder Woman in her sliding pose.
Yeah, and the gallery statues.
Mm-hmm.
But definitely, I love that scene in the movie and the bank and that. That music that's like a ripoff of Immigrant Song almost.
Mm.
It's pretty cool tune too. But
yeah, I have the Aquaman from this line down in my room, and then you still want to get the
Superman. Yeah, I want to find Supes for it. So anybody has him out there and they want to get rid of him, let me know. In the gallery.
And now
I've been finding all kinds of good deals on Star Wars books online. I got the newest encyclopedia coming, and I got several more I got watched on eBay, but I picked these up for like $3 a piece, and they're really
both
awesome books.
Character encyclopedias, so we have a cinematic one, lots of your favorites on it, and then we got a Clone Wars one. So,
show me inside how
it
just shows the characters and that.
Select a character.
Yeah, select.
Which who would you like to choose to show?
Hmm.
There's so many good ones.
Oh, I know. I was going to say go in here and go Cad Bane.
Oh, yeah? Well, I mean, we'll show both. We'll show Cad Bane in this one. This will give you sort of a feel
for... Would love if they put him in a movie. And I would love if... I don't know the guy's name that did the voice for him, but... It would be awesome if they kept the same guy.
Mm-hmm. No, we still need Ventress in the movie.
Ah, yeah, man.
Even
both of them would be awesome. Hondo, yeah.
Here, there he is, right next to C-3PO. This is what a standard page looks like.
Yeah, and it's like easy enough for kids to look at, but it's cool for adults too, because they have facts about each character and everything, and things they've been through.
Mm-hmm. Just like little...
Now, the big one, I'm getting the encyclopedia. It's a little more detailed.
You but, sure? I'm watching all the ones that I had. Like, it doesn't have, like, a Stormtrooper on
it. No, this is the brand. It's just got released.
Okay. Right, how about in the cinematic? Oh, I know what we can go to in the cinematic.
Yeah, you pick us since I picked the...
Look, right there. Look, even the writing's in purple. Oh, my gosh.
He's talking about Hondu.
Barrison again? Wait, where is he?
Where is he?
He has to be in here. Mm-hmm.
Hashtag Dude, Apollo Creed.
Just for you, we go to the ends.
Who you looking for? Ah, my man.
Your man for some random reason. Neen
Num.
Right next to Newt Gunray. So.
Two smooth voices.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, that's what they look like, so. You find some great deals on books these days on eBay. I still don't understand why. I know a lot of people went to, like the tablets and getting all their books on tablet. Man, it's just still something about, like, with books and CDs and DVDs, having the physical product in your hand that you can look at. And
mind needs books like a sword needs a whetstone.
It's, magical, I guess. But
Mine needs books.
Anyway, why don't you go grab your graduation present?
Oh gosh, I forgot to bring that up.
And here. I will discuss a few matters while you're on.
Keep that up here. Let me
see. Just a reminder, if you've you know, made it this far video, please, 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 please like and subscribe to the video and turn the bell notifications on. We would really, really, really appreciate it. We've been at this, what, about 8 months now, I think, and you know, still have yet to get our first 200, you know, we're about 135 subs right now. But man, if you could, you know, if you're watching this or you watch this regularly and you're not sub, please consider subbing. We'd really appreciate it, because we're going to try to keep the content coming as much as we can in the future, you know, especially Hunter's going to be going to school locally for college for the first couple of years, so he'll be around for us to continue to do videos, and I will do, you know, as long as I'm able to, I will keep doing them myself. And he has got his graduation gift, yeah, and has arrived.
So, for graduation, I was bestowed this retro Obi-Wan 6 scale figure from Sideshow.
Found an incredible deal from the toy department in Ohio.
I imagine the reason
we see on
probably
Josh and Cincy's and Toy Bills and them guys' videos all the time.
So yeah, just like a note, this isn't the newer one that's like the hot toy that's been released. It's still on pre-order and
right, yeah, there's a brand new one coming out, but that's probably why I have a feeling this may have been their display models, and they're probably getting ready for the new one, so they I don't know if that's a fact or not. But
no, this is an old one. This is from back before that even existed. There was a whole line of these. Like, this is the box. Lots of people probably recognize
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I really like the box. It's cool.
My favorite thing about this, I mean, the back there, you got like an Anakin and a Luke and a Kit Fisto. But my favorite aspect of this one is the accessories that it comes with. I mean, it opens up a bit, but you have all kinds of information. So here there's like blaster used to kill Grievous with, some extra hands, there's a comlink in there, the breathing apparatus, the hologram thing, I don't know what this is, and the base that he's got out with him, and then like there's a spare lightsaber hilt, like, but he's got a lot of display options, and you can take the cloak on and off of him, so
yeah, I thought it was really cool, huh? And they gave me an incredible deal up there at the toy department, so definitely check them out online if you would. I just had him crossing on eBay, and I knew where he was coming from, and I know they're very reputable, so I, because of you guys that have, we watched your videos, so they hooked me up, man. Really appreciate it, and he was very happy. He won a 6-scale figure for graduation. I said, well, I'll try to hook him up with one. So, end up getting him a retro one because he's a big Obi-Wan fan. So, I'm really happy about that.
Yeah, well, does it have a date on it, I wonder? When it was,
I would think it would have a date on it.
Down here.
Yeah, on the bottom.
2006.
Yeah, it's
pretty old.
When what, 13 years, so pretty cool.
That's what I'm saying. It was out probably
and pretty
back.
Cool, to, and he's in you know, mint condition, so definitely awesome. Was happy to get that for you, and how proud we were of you. And he made the first honors all year with his grades in the honor roll and being the honor society and that, and he
more or less.
Was well deserved. For him to get something nice like that. So, do you have anything to add before we wrap it up?
No, not really.
Don't really have any new metal news, guys. I've actually not been following things too closely with everything going on. I'm lucky I've been following all the pop culture stuff. So, but yeah, man, I guess in closing, I'll say you. Love you. Congratulations
on graduating.
You know everything to me. And I hope you have a very successful college career. And it's nothing but great things from here on out. So
I hope so.
Couldn't imagine anybody else. Me and my son, you're definitely the best kid a guy could ever imagine having. So thank you for that. Thank you for all you do for us, and for the person you are, and the way you are devoted to your family and friends is just so inspiring. So thank you, bud.
Certainly.
So it's gonna wrap it up for what we picked up here recently. Hopefully we'll maybe do a toy hunt or something this coming week. We've been wanting to go out and look around. We haven't because of my hospital stuff and everything he's had going on. So maybe in the next coming week we'll get a hunt in for you guys. Thanks for being patient with us for a new video. And, excited to see this man graduate tomorrow. It's going to be cool. Just a reminder, as always, try to do one random act of kindness this week and help make a difference in someone else's life. But being there for each other and kind to each other is what the world is all about and should be about. So always, show each other with love and respect. If you can help somebody, do it, man. So for more Ring Wars, Brett the Tank Downey, Crazy H.
The craziest of all H's.
We will be seeing you guys soon. Thank you. God bless. Have a wonderful, wonderful holiday weekend. Rock on. Peace, you guys.
Oh, dear.